it's really easy to feel, you know, well, I'm the only dark one in my family. Or, you know, my town is the only town in Puerto Rico where there are black people. But, you know, when you start thinking bigger than that, when you start thinking, you know, like, there are tens of millions of us in the Western Hemisphere. There are hundreds of millions of us in the world. It allows you to feel powerful.
Afro-Latino is not simple. Afro-Latino does not have borders. Afro-Latino is not something that you can explain in a very easy manner. Afro-Latino is something that you have to feel, that you have to see, that you have to understand, that you have to know the history about.
We are not just all Latinos. The Latino community has an array of different cultures. For example, there's the indigenous, there is the European, and of course there's the African presence.
Afro-Latinos are also any type of shade. So you can have Afro-Latinos who are light-skinned, you can have Afro-Latinos who are dark-skinned. It all depends on your heritage and your background and where you come from and where your family comes from.
The Afro-Latino Forum is a coalition of artists, academics, activists, and there are all these people working to make sure that these issues that are so very present in the lives of people of African descent and Latinos of African descent are brought to the forefront.
The fact that the forum is based in New York is unbelievable, because to me, New York's like this heart of like cultures, and you have so many different Afro-Latinos here in New York.
New York City is such a cosmopolitan city where people from different countries come here, and we're being able to represent an array of different culture.
And so to me, New York is really the base of Afro-Latinidad in the United States, precisely because it has roots from the Caribbean, from Latin America, from Central America as well, and also a very strong African-American community.
New York becomes sort of like this really central place that people can talk about this, not because of the numbers, but because of the power, but also really because of the potential for the people to do something.
But New York also has a very interesting history and a very far-reaching history in terms of relations between what one could consider the Latino and the African-American community.
That's one of the major goals of the forum, to help people understand their history, understand that they're connected to people all over the world, and to use that understanding to not only help people feel proud of who they are, but also to help people use that for political power, to combat racism in any ways that we can, to stop the violence in our own communities.